see if we can get that one made official.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, accompanied by two cousins representing Chase University, Thea.
There's been a lot of big matches thrown around here tonight, and Thea Hale has been on cloud nine since winning a big match of her own, becoming the number one contender to the NXT Women's Championship.
And her opponent, Cora, Jade.
Next premium live event for NXT is the Great American Bash on Sunday, July 30th. The summer tradition continues, and tickets are available now at Ticketmaster.com. Get ready for this one-on-one matchup. You take a look at Cora Jade. Look, jealousy always seems to get the best of Jade.
Cora Jade, one bad little sister looking to write her own ticket, Vic. She's different. I get it, but that's what's going to take this young lady straight.
Jealousy?
To the top.
Jealousy's going to take her to the top?
Riding her own ship, making her own plans. She called her own shots.
Well, I hear what you're saying. She also called a shot earlier when she said that Thea Hale was a glorified cheerleader. Do you agree with the comments?
You know what? I would agree with that 100%. Wait a minute. Up until about a month ago when she started getting expert dealings from Gulak. Yes, that's what I'm talking about, Vic.
And Charlie Dempsey.
And Charlie Dempsey. We've got the two guys running on coach and trainer of the year.
We saw Cora Jade interact with Dana Brooke. Glad that Dana Brooke cleared the air on her status. We were shocked, confused last week. Is Dana Brooke the most unappreciated superstar in WWE?
You know, Dana Brooke is stepping on a whole lot of toes coming back into NXT. And one of them is right in the middle of that ring, Cora Jade. And she just made put her on notice. Put her on notice, Vic. Bitch slap. Sometimes I feel like doing that to you sometimes.
Well, let's not get too carried away. As the resident mean girl certainly is. Oh, there is Dana Brooke after the slap we saw earlier from Jade. Now Jade's got to worry about not only Dana Brooke, but the MVP, Duke Hudson, on the outside, not to mention Thea Hale in the ring.
I don't like this right here. This is a distraction. And right now, Cora Jade is trying to get back on track, and she does not need this because Thea Hale is definitely, she's ready for this moment.
I talked to Thea Hale last week, asked her about never losing her confidence. She said that Mr. Chase told her on day one, never fear defeat. Defeat is the secret ingredient to success. As Thea Hale taking down Cora Jade, and also thinking about Mr. Chase, are you concerned as much as Duke Hudson is about the calls going right to voicemail? He seemed a little worried about Chase.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you right now, Andre Chase checked out, in my estimation, a long time ago.
He checked out bookies, he's not 100%.
Like I said, sometimes you may not be able to come and put the work in, but you still show up at the job. You know, you understand what I'm saying? You're like you, Vic. Last week you had a cold, but you showed up.
And we're covering a hook of the leg and a kick out by Thea.
Sounded like you had a cold.
Now I'll take that as a backhanded compliment. It's Cora Jade right to the stomach. And when will Jade look in the mirror and point the finger for her shortcomings? You can't keep telling me all this stuff and not actually realize that she just continues to blame everyone else. And she goes into a cover, hooks the inside leg, and a kick.
You know, I don't know why you keep talking like that. Cora Jade, like I said, she may be different than every one of those young ladies in the locker room. She has the most utmost potential to be one of the best in this business. And I'm not just saying that. I'm not a fan or anything like that. I'm looking at her talent, Vic.
Now downplayed Thea Hale's Battle Royal win. Blame Dana Brooke, who is ringside, for the loss. Certainly the NXT Women's Champion, watching this match closely, because Thea Hale is the number one contender to the NXT Women's title, and finally creating a little bit of separation. Back to what your point was, a little bit of the teachings from Gulak and Dempsey.
You got to understand the confidence, the undeniable, the belief in yourself. And that right there is what Thea Hale has gotten over this last 3 weeks. That may be the one thing she needs.
Well, not only that, she certainly has toughened up as well over the last few weeks, along with picking up an offensive repertoire on a nice suplex, and Jade screaming in pain.
Have you ever seen one of Drew's sessions?
Look at this. This is what Thea Hale calls boing.
What?
When she calls it, you can talk to her about it. Thea Hale is almost like she drinks nothing but caffeinated coffee. Big suplex again. It's like the little engine that goes. No, never stops.
You're seeing a whole lot different with Thea Hill right now. The balance. Oh! Got caught right there, slipping.
Talk about balance. I just had the sense of balance knocked out. And, whoa! Wait a minute. Wait. And poor Jade. What's she doing now? Jade's gonna get disqualified. Again, great job by the officials. Oh, the official didn't see Dana Brooke.
Wow.
And that's going to open the door for Thea Hale. And Hale now, with all that coaching,
Dana Brooke
going right in.
And
look at Hale. Kimura lock. Cinch.
I can't believe this.
Is Jade going to tap? Yes, she has to. Nowhere to go.
Here is your winner by submission, Thea Hale.
Look, I got to agree with you. Drew and Charlie playing dividends for Thea Hale.
Yeah, like I said, she's learned a few tricks.
Talk about a trick. Well, there was no treat here for Cora Jade, the official. Again, our officials have done an excellent job here tonight on NXT, but Dana Brooke saw her opportunity, a little payback for that slap earlier tonight. And as we mentioned, open the door for Thea Hale to use some of that education, that Kimura lock. Cinched in, tightly wrapped, nowhere for Cora Jade to go as the prize pupil builds more momentum on her way towards Tiffany Stratton and the NXT Women's Championship.